Hello class 10th, in the last video we are reading about the pH value and the strength of acids and bases, universal indicator. Okay, so this pH of many things, they have an importance in our everyday life. Whatever we eat, whatever we consume or whatever we use for our body has some pH. Not only our body, in the environment pH is very much required, very much important. Like pH of our digestive system, okay, basically our digestive system has a pH value of about let's go for this thing, acidic pH. Okay, our stomach has acidic pH, okay, because it produces hydrochloric acid. Okay, so the pH was around 1.4. Okay, so sometimes we suffer from a condition called as hyperacidity. Hyperacidity means a large amount of hydrochloric acid is produced that is not being used, and it causes irritation in our stomach's inner lining. And we face problems. We suffer by hyperacidity. We feel the pain. We feel the burning sensation. Okay. So here the pH drops below this limit. Okay. So to treat it, we use an antacid. Okay. We call it as antacid. Antacid means, anta means it is against. And acid means this antacid is a medicine which works against acids. Okay, it works against acids. It neutralizes the effect of excessive hydrochloric acid. Okay, so basically they are bases which neutralize acids. Clear? The bases neutralizes acids. Like we can use magnesium hydroxide. Okay, we use as magnesium hydroxide. Clear? This is called as milk of magnesia. Clear? So here the pH of digestive system is very important. Okay, like basically it is acidic nearby 1.4, but if it drops down below its limit, we will suffer from a condition called as hyperacidity. In such condition, we may feel the burning sensation and pain in our inner lining of stomach, which will create a problem for us. So we take bases as they work like antacids. Okay, example is magnesium hydroxide. There are many other bases like AlOH3, aluminum hydroxide gel. Okay, so they give relief from this condition of hyperacidity. Clear? This bases react with the acids and neutralize it, and we get relief from pain and burning sensation. Okay, second thing, pH change as the cause of tooth decay. Okay, pH change as the cause of tooth decay. Basically, we eat foods which mainly contain sugar. Okay, if you're not cleaning our teeth properly, the sugar is stuck in the mouth, and when sugar is left over in mouth, some bacteria feed upon the sugar to produce acids. Okay, these acids, they may damage the enamel layer of teeth. This enamel layer, it is the strongest part of our body. Okay, it is made up of calcium phosphate. It is made up of calcium phosphate. Okay, let me show the structure of teeth. This is the enamel layer. This is the dentine layer. This is the pulp layer. Clear? When acids attack, they may damage the enamel layer. After damaging it, they may also damage the dentine layer. And if so happens, they pressurize the pulp. Okay, they affect the pulp. This creates a severe pain in teeth. Clear? Means if tooth decay occurs, it may affect the pulp and cause severe pain to us. Okay, so this happens when the pH falls up to 5.5 or below it. Okay, what I have told you that sugar, they will be decomposed by the bacteria to form acids. And if the acid secretion is very high, which may cause the fall of pH up to 5.5 or below it, this will cause tooth decay. Clear? This will cause tooth decay. So this can be treated by using toothpaste. Okay, which is quite basic. Its pH is around 8. Okay, its pH is around 8. So if the pH changes, normally the tooth has a pH of around 6.5 approx. If it falls down below 5.5, you will suffer from tooth decay. To prevent it, we use the toothpaste of pH about 8. Clear? Okay, third. If we see, the pH is very important for our environment also, like for soil, for water. Okay, if the pH of the soil, it decreases. Okay, if it decreases due to some acidic chemicals that that come through the factories, then we may use a mild base. Okay, agar soil acidic ho jata hai to hum usme kya mild base use kar sakte hain to neutralize the soil. Kya use karenge? Calcium hydroxide. We can use calcium hydroxide. Clear? If suppose if suppose the soil has become some basic, agar soil basic ho gaya hai thoda, we'll use a mild acid. Mild acid kya use karenge? Vinegar that contains acetic acid, CH3COOH. Clear? If the soil has become acidic, we will use mild base. If the soil has become basic, we will use a mild acid, acetic acid. Clear? This also is a problem for water bodies. If the water body basically their pH is around 7, but sometimes due to acid rain or the factories, they discharge their acidic waste into the water bodies, so water becomes acidic. Why? Because of mainly acid rain or acidic waste from factories. If this happens, what will happen? The pH will decrease down and the aquatic animals and plants may suffer. They may die. So here also we will use calcium hydroxide, a mild base, okay, which will neutralize the effect of this acid and bring the pH to normal state. Okay, now pH, again, it helps in self-defense also. Like many animals, such as honeybee. Honeybee's sting, okay, sorry, honeybee's sting has formic acid. Okay, honeybee sting has formic acid. If this insect is being disturbed by any person, it stings and inject formic acid into the body. This will cause a pain, okay, moderate to severe pain. Clear? So here the animals are using what? Their acids or bases for their self-defense. Okay, this can be treated by using baking soda, okay, whose formula is NaHCO3, okay, sodium bicarbonate. Okay, as because it is basic in nature. I have told you metal carbonates, metal bicarbonates, metal oxides, they are basic in nature. As because it is an acid and acid is being injected to our body, we can neutralize the effect of acid by using a basic substance. This is a basic substance. Clear? Next, if we go to wasp sting, let's go to ant sting. Okay, ant sting, it also contains formic acid. Okay, this can be treated in the same method. Clear? If we go to wasp sting, okay, wasp sting contains alkaline liquid. It doesn't alkaline, it doesn't contain any acid. Okay, it contains base. Okay, so this base will also cause a severe pain. Okay, so here it can be neutralized by using vinegar. Okay, means acetic acid. So here we come to know that the animals too use this thing for, okay, so what I was telling, so here the animals use their acid or bases as chemical warfare, okay, for their self-defense. Okay, the last one is, there is a tree, okay, nettle plant, okay, nettle plant. It is somewhat of this structure. You can take a look over this. Okay, these leaves has spines over it, stinging hair over it. Okay, so they inject methanoic acid. Okay, they inject methanoic acid. It's also called as formic acid. Clear? Nettle plant has a sting hair which injects methanoic acid or formic acid. It causes severe pain. As because it injects acid, we can use a base when we go home back. But what happens? Okay, so this acid can be neutralized by base, that we can use sodium, sodium bicarbonate. But nature has other technique for you. Behind every nettle plant, there is a duck plant. Okay, nettle plant ke piche har waqt duck plant hota hai. So if methanoic acid is being injected in your body through nettle plant, we can use the leaves of duck plant, okay, as a remedy. If we rub the duck plant in the skin where we have been injected the methanoic acid, the effect of methanoic acid will be neutralized. Nettle plant jahan pe body mein laga aur hame methanoic acid mila hai. Okay, so wahan pe agar duck plant ka leaf ko hum rub karte hain to ye hamara pain ko aur us acid ke effect ko neutralize kar dega. ये एक नेचुरल एडजस्टमेंट है. क्लियर? क्योंकि जंगल में तो हमको सोडियम कार्बोनेट, सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट मिलेगा नहीं, हम जानते हैं. सो नेचर हैज प्रोवाइडेड द प्रॉब्लम प्लस द सॉल्यूशन टू अस, कि अगर तुम नेटल प्लांट से टकराते हो, अगर तुम्हें मेथनोइक एसिड इंजेक्ट होता है तुम्हारे बॉडी में, तो तुम उसके पीछे ही डॉग प्लांट होता है, ठीक, उसके पीछे हर जगह. क्लियर? तो दिस इज अबाउट द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ पीएच इन आवर लाइफ, डेली लाइफ. सो I shall give you the notes about it. Just go through the video properly. If you face any kind of problem, tell me, okay? Have a good day.